Hey guys, we got a LCT 4.8 horsepower engine that I picked up at Surplus Center over in Lincoln, Nebraska. Now they've got a website online. Now this was not given to me. I'm not sponsored by them. I purchased this, picked it up for $50 plus shipping, $49.95. And I thought you guys might want to see what it is, if they're any good or not. And for $50, I mean, how can a man go wrong, really? Let's see. The box is thick. They packed it good. Oh yeah, I love this stuff. It's hard to get rid of, but for packing stuff, it's got the foam. I love the expanding foam. I love that stuff. Whatever you're shipping, it'll keep it safe. Getting rid of it on the other end, though, that's the trick. Okay. And, oh, lots and lots and lots. This is a job in itself right here. Okay, I'll get this box out of the way. Oh, knock it off the table. Is that everything? All right, so what we got here? Ooh, and there it is. Can you guys see that? Mr. Cameraman, look okay?
Yep, we got everything right here and there.
Comes with a pull start handle, and the pull start rope is tied off in a knot. So I guess they're gonna let you choose whether you use the snow handle or install a regular one. I see that it's got two keys with it. Now this is this LCT 4.8 horsepower snow blower. The engine is what they came off of. These are brand new, supposedly, and I think I have to agree with that. This is new. That's never had fuel in it, looks like. So we got a fuel line, and we got a primer pump, and there is no gas tank. Now these are horizontal shafts, so they'll work on go-karts and mini bikes, and that's a 3/4 inch, and that looks about right. So I like this deal. I like that. There's no gas tank though, so whatever you're mounting it on, you're gonna have to mount a gas tank somewhere else, unless it's got a couple of mounts here. I don't know if the Honda tank will fit or the clone tank would fit. I don't know. But let's see. I don't think they got any oil in there. Shouldn't be. Well, it looks like it's touching on the bottom of the stick, but we'll, well, that's loose. Well, we'll tighten that up and we'll get some oil in this thing. LCT. Okay, let's get a little closer look here. Alrighty, has the that's definitely a clone carburetor. It's got a carburetor block off plate, so there's no air filter, you know, unless you're putting this on a snow blower, you're gonna have to add an air filter on there. But I would probably rather have the aftermarket anyway. But a lot of the guys have a, okay, there's a breather pipe for the valve cover. Oh, I like that. I like that. That's got the drain on the bottom of the carburetor. Of course, you know, that's not really uncommon on these. But I did some research on these things online. And LCT is an American-owned company, or an American company. But, you know, and they try to make it look like these are made in the U.S., but
I think their production facilities is based in China, according to their website. And besides that, you know, I'm looking, and you guys are probably seeing the same thing I am. We're looking at a 179cc Chinese clone. And, you know, that's okay. Some things I did learn about this, supposedly, it's supposed to be a dual bearing engine. So we've got a bearing on the flywheel side of the crank and a bearing on the output side of the crank. So that's good. As you guys can see, I mean, that's just a standard shaft. No surprises there. 3/4 inch, got the standard keyway, I think. Probably, I don't know, 1/4 inch keyway, maybe less. So, yeah. And I do like the oil filler. I like that. I know that might be an issue with some guys, depending on, you know, how much clearance you got, but I don't think it'd be an issue, really. Yeah, the muffler. That's kind of, yeah, I don't know. If you got that on a, put that on a mini bike, let's see. This is going to be blowing out on your legs. So I don't know, but somebody, you know, you could come up with a fix for that. Put a pipe here with a bit, like a 45 bend and come back. So that would probably take care of that. But I do like this. Now this is cool, the little key system. You know, you plug these little plastic rascals in here, and when they pull it out, it dies. So now that's pretty cool. You could put one of those on your mini bike or scooter or whatever. It'll be going on my tiller. I don't know. I'll probably just disconnect this. I don't really need it. But, there's the primer. Okay. And on this handle, I don't know. That's a snow handle. I'm really not going to be using this in the wintertime, so I'll probably just go with a standard size pull on there. Okay, big truck going by. But I think most of you guys have probably seen enough of these to know we're looking at a 179cc Chinese clone. But it does have the fuel tank mounts. So, hey, you know, that's a plus. There's going to be plenty of fuel tanks, especially used ones, out there a man can pick up. And even a new one, you know, just a few bucks. I don't think it's going to cost that much. So it's definitely not a Hemi head. But, hey, we got a sticker down there. What's the sticker say? Oh. Well, that's kind of sideways, isn't it? Oh. Will it hurt the engine? It ain't going to hurt it. That's probably not the best thing for it, but get it up here where we can read the sticker and see what that says. Focus for me, please. Okay. Winter use only. Yeah. I guess that's because of the lack of an air filter. But, you know, we could stick an air filter on there. And you could pause a video or something if you want to read all the specs. I'm not going to bore you to death with reading all through that junk. But, let's see. I think I've got another 179cc clone over on a mini bike. Hang on a second. Bring you right back. Okay. Now, this little Coleman CT200U. I don't think it's got the 179. I think it's got like a 197 on there. And let's see, but yeah. Fuel tank mount is different in the front. Yeah. Yeah, the other ones are straight up and down, and this is set up at like an angle. So, that might be different. Yeah. Yeah, different. Well, I don't think I've got another 179cc engine in here to compare it to. you guys don't mind the mess. And I've got a Predator over there new in the box. Let's see. He's a, that's a 212 though. Oh gosh, me and my junk. Let's see. Well, I'm not gonna dig him out from underneath the bench. Okay, now how did I get in here? All right, knock the ladder down. All right, that's great. Yeah, remember to trim this out. So, and let's see, this one also has the 197cc, and the tank mounts are different on it too. Well, shoot, I just don't have a lot of similarities on that side cover though. I just don't have another 179 to compare with. But I'm fairly certain. No, I'm certain it's a Chinese production engine. Now that don't mean it's bad. I'm sure there's lots of good parts for the 179cc's as well. Yeah. So she's looking pretty good. Oh, sorry guys. Yeah, that governor will be disconnected. I don't know, if I put this on the tiller, I'll leave the governor on it. May have to do some adjusting though, because I think snow blowers run at full throttle most of the time. I don't know, that'd be something we'll have to get into later when we start mounting this thing on there. But not too bad. Was it worth it? Yeah. Yeah, definitely. Matter of fact, before I put this video out, I'll probably order a couple more, because I think these are probably going to go pretty fast. But overall view, I think it's a pretty good deal. You know, you're going to have to buy your air cleaner or use one off another clone engine that you've replaced with a good air filter. Or you could go ahead and buy the good air filter and put it on there to begin with. Would probably be better. And a fuel tank. If your application doesn't already have a fuel tank on it, you're going to have to find one somewhere. So, you know, that's money. It's things to consider, too. You know, spend up $30 for a fuel tank and then, you know, $15 for air cleaner, well, then you're going to get upwards of $100 in this thing. And for just a little more, you know, you can go ahead and get you the Harbor Freight 212, or hopefully soon the 224cc Harbor Freight engine. And that's in the works. As soon as they list them on the website, we'll get one of those and look at it. But LCT 4.8 horsepower 179cc engine. Snowblower engine with warranty, $49.95 plus shipping. Is it worth it? Yeah, I think it's worth it. I think it's a good buy. Okay, guys, see you next time. A few carb adjustments, but you guys didn't think I was going to end the video without letting you hear it run, did you? Shame on you.